What's up, guys? I'm in the garage right now getting some work done. I own some No Sleep Team shirts. I'm playing around with packaging them up, and I'm about to run to the post office. I've got some bracelets back there I need to ship out. And yeah, I figured I would test some more stuff with shipping. So I went ahead and packaged up this shirt. This is a large shirt, ready to go, completely packed. Oh, well, let me show you this. These are No Sleep Team shirts that I was printing last night because I was getting stressed about the print press, which I'll probably talk about later, or the heat press. I was trying to press some shirts and I did like one or two crooked. Thankfully, they were for like family members, so it wasn't that bad. But I finally figured out how to use this stupid little T-tool to measure my shirts. I'll show you guys that later. But this is the final product. Look at that. These are all XL shirts. I went ahead and did like a few XLs and put them in the packaging, and that looks nice. Look at that. No sleep team. That's good packaging right there. So yeah, that took me like an hour to 2 hours to do like 9 shirts. So obviously this is going to take a while. This is going to be a process, and I'll get faster at it as I do it too. But this package right here, what I'm trying to do, I made this little cutout. This is just like the UPS cutout. This under 3/4 of an inch. You have to be able to fit packages through this if you want to send it as a large envelope. So that's what I'm trying to do, because I think our t-shirts, we may be able to get a little bit cheaper if someone buys an individual t-shirt to ship them out if it's in a bubble mailer. But yeah, what I'm trying to do is, like, I can't really do this one hand. I'm going to set you guys down. So yeah, this cutout is to pretty much do this. You put the package through it and see if it's going to fit. All right, so it's hanging up a little bit. It needs to be a little bit tighter. I don't know. I guess that's good. I'm gonna bring these to the post office, because I know if they do get hung up a little bit, they will sometimes be picky about that, but that freaking fits too. I don't need to go bubble mailers. I think these bags are gonna be good. I just gotta make the post office work with me. I gotta be like, all right, this is thinner. I can see that it fits too. Take it, dang it. Now, this is a large shirt, so anything above an XL shirt is gonna be able to go in one of these bags for sure, because they're gonna be too thick, and you can't send those in a bubble mailer as a large envelope. They're gonna be thicker than 3/4 no matter what. So yeah, I know it's probably gibberish to you guys, but I'm just figuring this stuff out in my head. Getting No Sleep Team shirts ready. I know you guys are probably like, oh my god, where is the pre-orders for the shirts and hoodies? But soon. We have an issue right now with the plugin on our website, which we're going to try to get that figured out today. We had to wait till a business day so we could talk to someone online. And we're going to get that figured out so all the shipping works properly on our site, because we're having issues with it right now. Once we get that sorted out, the pre-orders are pretty much ready to go up. And as soon as we can get these t-shirts pressed and packaged up and ready to send out to you guys, is as fast as they can go out to you. So we're trying to hurry. We're making the process as quick as possible. And just be patient with us. It's a lot of work. All right, time to head to the post office. I'm going to try out the different shipping methods with all these like packagings and stuff, and I'm gonna send out these bracelets. Let go. Bye, girl. I love you. So I just left the house, and when I was a good ways away, not like too far, just annoyingly enough, when I had to come back, Gray sends me a voice iMessage thing where you can like pick your phone up and just like hold it to your ear and it'll play it for you. She was like, pick up some paper towels and get some toothpaste, because I'm completely out. Like, I have no toothpaste left. And then I was like, dang it, if I'm doing that, I'm going to Target, because there's a Starbucks in Target, which I'm going to Starbucks while I'm out, of course. And then I was like, I need to return this thing. The little containers I got the other day for my clothes. One of them, like, the lid is cracked. So I've got to return that. So I was like, why not do it all at once? But I've got videos edit. Why is there not enough time during the day? Like, I want there to be more time during the day so I can get more work done. Seriously, though, more time during the day would be awesome. Somebody make that happen. Holding windows down. Cruise. It was amazing outside. In search of containers. Ta-da. There we go. All right, so I'm just going to grab a new one of these. This is it. Yep. All right. Ta-da. All right, so I went in and checked the shipping, and I've got some good news. I checked the shipping of a small t-shirt and a medium t-shirt. This time we brought them packaged up, ready to go, and they will send as a large envelope, which means under 3/4 of an inch, which means the shipping is gonna be cheaper for you guys if you buy a single individual shirt by itself in small, medium, and possibly large. Either way, the shipping's still gonna be as cheap as possible, but anything bigger than that we have to send is like a over 3/4 inch package, so it makes it a little bit more expensive, but yeah, that brings down the price of shipping, so. Plus, yes, better. Woo! Saving you guys money. Spent so much time trying to figure that out. Oh my god. So glad to have that done. Oversized load. What is this? What the freak is that? What is this gigantic thing coming down the road? Yo, really, what is that? I've never seen anything like that. I just seen there's a truck that said oversized load, like driving in front of it. Oh god. Also, we have two freaking packages from you guys. Take a peek on video. I don't know if I'm gonna show you, because again, we're gonna do a viewer mail soon.
I've gotta put the keys in this car though. It's hot. I am burning up. I'm starting to sweat. Get a little sip of cold Starbucks.
Tastes really good with some breath freshening gum. I was gonna use my keys to open that up. Now I'm gonna use Grace Hair Club. Oh no, I'm not. You just gotta get it started. That's all you gotta do. The Amazon tape is easy to rip. What did you guys get us this time?
Oh, somebody got Mac a Kong Goodie Bone. He is going to love that. The Kong bones are so good. He actually had one, I think, just like this, but smaller maybe. He is going to love that.
You have no idea how much Mac loves these Kong toys. They're so strong, they last forever. Oh my, he's gonna love that. Thank you to whoever sent that. Again, you have to put your name with your Amazon thing. You have to put it in like the gift note if you get us something. Don't get us something, but I don't know. The only way I could stop it is closing my P.O. box, and I can't do that because I need it as a business. So don't send us stuff. Don't buy us stuff. I know I'm showing it on video, and it's making you guys want to do it more, but I'm showing it because you guys are sending us stuff, and I feel bad if I don't. I should have saved that for viewer mail, but I guess it's for Mac, so it doesn't really matter.
What is this?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, I'm gonna put that back in the packaging. I'm not showing that on the vlog, guys. I'm sorry. Does this one have a name? Yeah, I'm not surprised this one doesn't have a name on it.
Little kids do not need to see that.
I'm gonna be.
What are you doing? Huh? Hey, what are you doing? So I had it sitting on the counter. I was actually about to give it to him and vlog it. And he like grabbed it off the counter and went over there. But he knew, he was like, wait a minute, am I supposed to have this? Because he was kind of like just barely holding on to it. Normally, if he knows this is a toy, he'll hold on to it tight. Yeah, do you want it? It's yours. It's your bonus from a viewer. Somebody sent it for you. Yeah. Get it. You ready? Get off the couch. You got, no, you don't get off the couch that way, donkey. All right, sit. Sit. Lay down. Lay down. That's a good boy. Shh. All right, get up. All right, bag. Oh, gosh. He wants that bone. Good boy. That's a bigger one than his last one. That's a nice bone. Yeah. All right. It's a sweet t-shirt.
You scared me.
It's a sweet t-shirt.
Thank you.
I really like it a lot.
You can get them at nosleepteam.com. Ew!
I didn't sneeze on you. I sneezed down.
You could have.
It's not covering up the microphone, so the microphone should have access there. There's a microphone hole right there. And cutting some No Sleep Team designs. Look at this. We got a pile of them things. No Sleep Team designs. Ready to go on shirts for you guys. So the cutting process is so much simpler. Since I got that T-tool, I don't have to worry about how I cut these and measure it then. I can just cut them into like separate designs because there's like three on a sheet. And that's pretty much it. I go like this. I've got three. Shut up. I've got three stacked up here. I just slide it over. Slide it over to Ange right there. And look at that. Three T-shirt designs ready to go. One, two, three. Booyah. And I lay it on the pile. And then I cut some more. So what I'm doing right now, I'm just trying to cut the designs so when I actually do go to press a bunch of shirts, they are ready.
This is going to be a special surprise.
Well, you got to tell them what you're ready to do.
No. They can't know. It's special.
They're going to know.
It's special.
Recording is going to be doing that, counting down.
All right, you guys. We're going in for the kill. Let's go see what we can find. You ready? All right, you guys, we're in the car. I don't see anybody. And we're off. Let's do this. Hey, you guys, thought I'd point this out while I was taking a little ride. Look how pretty that sky is. I mean, seriously. It is like beautiful, gorgeous blue, and then you have pink, the pink clouds from the reflection off the sun. It is like almost cotton candy color. Like, that is really pretty. I just thought I'd point that out Couldn't help it. And, yeah, we're still on the road. We'll be there shortly. Yeah. This is exciting. You guys don't even know where you're going. This is so exciting. I love surprises. We believe in Jesus. Alright, you guys. Look at this. Look how pretty. Now it's like pink, purple, and blue. I mean, that is just gorgeous. Can't say it's not. I don't know if you guys believe in God, but I do. And I believe that He makes a beautiful picture for us every single day. We just have to open our eyes and look. Might not be in the sky, it might be somewhere else. But yeah. And then over here to the left, we got some pretty clouds, pretty sky. Just really beautiful. I love it. Wow. It's gorgeous. I just can't get over it. We're almost there, I promise. It's gonna be really exciting. I'm excited. All right, you guys, you know I'm not really good at this vlogging. I really am totally embarrassed to go into this store. Hint, hint. And video myself talking to you guys, because people will stare at me and they'll think I'm crazy. But we'll see what happens. I've not planned anything. I have no idea what I'm gonna say. We'll just see what happens. Yep. And we're going in. And guess what? We're getting groceries. How exciting is that? You know people like to eat, so you know. It is what it is. Alright, you guys. I've spotted a strange puddle. We're gonna vlog it. Let's see. Have you ever seen anybody push a buggy that doesn't push the buggy? They actually are beside the buggy? Yeah, we're gonna find these people. Hang on. Can you really look at people and watch them? It's hilarious. People are funny. People watching is one of the best things ever. Here we go. Alright guys, things are not going as planned. I've not seen too many things happen in the grocery store. So I lied. Okay. I thought there might have been a couple things going to happen. Nothing too great. But you know, you just never know. Never know what you're going to see. But we'll keep looking. I'm not done yet. So we'll see what else we can find. Alright you guys. So I totally failed. I tried to make this an interesting vlog. Didn't see nothing much. Just a couple weird things. Sorry, I tried. Just a couple of kids getting on parents' nerves. A weird couple holding hands while pushing a buggy. And they didn't walk behind the buggy either. It was really strange. I wanted to get that on video, but yeah. Didn't get to get that. And then I successfully failed at the checkout. That's okay. I'm still okay. So, yeah. So, on to our next adventure. Time to go home and cook. Alright, so I guess I'll just like, if you guys can see me, hopefully you can. I'll just entertain you on the way home. How about that? It is kind of dark, I know. We'll turn a little light on the subject. Yeah. Well, so you want to hear about my day? Like usual, I woke up. Yeah, everything was great. Got ready, took me a nice shower, had my cup of coffee. I love my coffee. That's the one thing I have to have in the morning, right when I wake up, is my cup of coffee. It's divine. Can't start my day without it. And then I get on the internet for a few minutes, you know. Check my email, look at my bank account. Try to, you know, always do things while my mind's fresh, you know, because you've just rested for the whole night. So you can pretty much, you know, think of ideas, things that, you know, turn off the vlog for a sec. Well, we'll just hold on. How about that? Okay. Yeah. So my day always starts off with a good, fresh cup of coffee. And, yeah, get on the internet, look at a few things, get me a nice warm shower, and get ready for work as quick as possible, obviously. Look at my hair. Yeah, I gotta do something with my hair. Yeah, I'm getting tired of it. When I work, you know, it's not unusual to pull my hair up in a ponytail. You know, big deal. You guys see it like that every time you probably watch the vlogs. But, I'm about ready for a little change, you know. Some things are gonna change. Yeah, some things are gonna change. About ready to turn over a new leaf, you know, getting a little older. It sucks getting old, by the way, you know. I'm not gonna tell you guys how old I am. Because you guys don't care, obviously. But, yeah. Getting older just really, really, it just stinks, man, you know? Like, time flies by way too fast. You're grown before you know it, you know. And, you know, the older you get, the faster time seems to fly. It's just inevitable. It's just going to. You know, in today's life, too many things are distracting constantly. So that's why I like to say, you know, slow down sometimes. Let your mind rest and just enjoy the moment. It don't have to be you doing anything. It can just be you, you know, it could be you sitting there in the car getting ready to get out to go into the grocery store just like I did. You know, some people are your mind is physically all the time thinking about what you're about to do, what you're about to do, what you're about to do. And so many things are happening at that moment that we're not enjoying. When you really, really think about that, that's scary because you're missing some very, very valuable things in your life. You're missing, you know, how you feel at that very present. Because you're constantly thinking about your future. Constantly. You know, okay, I'm about to go in this grocery store and I'm about to pick up these items. Okay? It really sucks when you think about it like that. You know, why can't we think of life as in the present? It's very hard. You know, and there's very little times that people actually stop and, you know, stop doing things. Just sit there and just, you know, whatever you're doing right at that moment, stop and think about that and only that and enjoy it. Hey, I'm coming up with some good stuff here. Just kidding. But, it's really, if you think about it, oh, a kitty cat is trying to go out in front of me. But if you think about it, you know, that's really something to ponder on, you know. I guess to make yourself realize, you know, I'm not enjoying the present time that I'm in. I'm constantly thinking about what I'm about to do, what I'm going to do, when I'm never enjoying the moment. You know, when I work, let me give you this quick little thing. When I'm working, I don't really want to do what I'm about to do when I am at work. But what I do, I know it sounds funny, is I think about, you know, that person that I'm going to work on, right? And I think about, you know, how can I make their day better? You know, because I just like people in general. I love people. I care about people. I'm a caregiver. But I think about, you know, what can I do to improve their life at this moment? What can I say to them or do for them to make them feel better and to let them know that I care about them? I know this is getting kind of deep, but, you know, it is what it is. But, yeah, I clean teeth. So, you know, I just like to, you know, strike up a little conversation, you know. I'm just, you know, I'm a girl, so I'm, you know, more kind-hearted toward people. I don't, you know, like I said earlier, I don't know if you guys believe in God or Jesus or whatnot, but there is not a day that goes by since I have been saved that I do not feel like He lives in me. And that's my honest to God opinion. I feel like every choice, most choices that I do make are through his example, the way he would want us to do it. I try to live that way. So whenever I clean someone's teeth, I want to show them that I care about them, that I truly care about them, that they are the most important thing at that moment, that, you know, to show them kindness and love, because you don't know, you know, what every person in this world deals with on a regular daily basis. You do not know. Anyway, I'm probably boring you guys to death. I'm just trying to give you guys some thoughts, you know. This was supposed to be an exciting trip to the grocery store. Guess what? It's exciting, right? Right. Okay. No, I'm just kidding. But anyway, yeah. This is me vlogging. Should I do my own channel? I mean, tell me. Come on, tell me. Would it be a good idea? Not doing that. I don't have time, people. I don't have time. And besides that, I'm crazy enough. If I sit here and actually talk to myself all the time on a vlog camera, you know what? Actually, I probably should start vlogging because I do it anyway. So why not talk to you guys, right? No, I'm not doing that. All right. And I'm definitely not watching this vlog because this vlog, I will say, oh my gosh, I look ridiculous because I know what it is. I'm just kidding. I'm not going to judge myself. You know, it is what it is at this moment. I know I don't look great. Whatever. It is what it is. It's not about what's on the outside. It's about what's on the inside. You've got to love yourself inside. And then the outside will look gorgeous. Just gorgeous. So if you're happy and you express love to others, you will beam with beauty. You will be the most gorgeous person. Because let me tell you, happiness is beautiful. Love is beautiful. Hey, I could go on and on. Let me give you guys a sneak peek of my neighborhood, okay? Here we go. I'm gonna turn the lights out. Cool. What do you guys think? These people have really outdone themselves. Yeah, that's what I think. Pretty gruesome, huh? Yeah, so my neighborhood's having like a, you know, a contest. The most Halloween decorated yard or whatnot wins, you know, money or what, whatever. Eh, I didn't do too much this year. I'm just like, you know, I ain't feeling it. Little thing on the door, maybe a pumpkin, you know, a couple fall decorations. I'm good. Yeah. But, gotta figure out where to park. Yeah. We're here though, you guys. We have arrived. We are at our second destination, which is the house. Let's go see what everybody's doing. All right, you guys, I had an idea. We're gonna act like Ty and Gray, you know, when they come to the house and they start vlogging when they walk in the door. So I'm gonna vlog as I walk in the door. You guys can see what everybody's doing, okay? Here we go. We're here, you guys, look. Look, yeah. It's a Mackie shoe.
Is it a fun adventure?
Yes. Oh, they're very well entertained. You'll see. It was all exciting at first, right? Yeah. But nah, it kind of didn't turn out that way. It turned out a little different in the end. You'll see.
Oh, God. All right, guys, who's ready to heat press some friggin' t-shirts? Let's do this. First, we gotta turn the heat press on. Let's flip the switch. For some reason, the counter, the timer thing on it hasn't been working, and I even set the time on it, but yeah, it just, I don't know, maybe I need to do it again. I don't know, I'm just gonna go with it, because I was pressing shirts before the other night, and I wasn't using the timer, because all you had to do is like count to 10, and then I go beep, 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 and that's when I lift up the press. All right, so I'm letting this thing heat up. It's already at 72. It goes up to 350. That's what temperature I put it on to press shirts. And then I'm going to start pressing these designs onto these t-shirts. Oops. Hey, baby. He's so excited.
Is that your bedroom attire?
Psst.
Meh.
He will lick your face off.
Yeah, see, I love to get kisses. All right, we are ready to roll. The heat press is heated up now. It's actually down to 347, but it's been at 350. It's heated up enough. I know it is. I kind of get like fluctuates a little bit, which is fine. A few degrees isn't gonna hurt it. I'll just press it a second or two extra. And yeah, my shirt's already lined up. I've already measured it. Now, actually, I'm gonna get Gray out here to video really quick so I can show you the process that it takes to actually measure up and make sure each shirt is perfectly aligned on this heat press. I know there's a better way to do it, and I know you can do it by eye, but I want to make sure these shirts are perfect because I wouldn't want to wear something that's crooked, and I know you guys wouldn't too. So I'm trying to do it right, and yeah, I'll show you the process now. All right, here we go. All right, so I'm gonna set a timer. I want to see how long it. Oh wow, there's already a stopwatch going. I just stopped it. I don't even know how long that is.
That's how probably you like checking to see how far one place is from another.
If I remember to stop it, I will see how many shirts I made and how long of time, just to kind of give me an idea of how long it's going to take. And obviously, I'll get better at it, so I want to try to improve every time I do it. So here we go. Start. So first, I guess I'll show you my setup. So I've got my t-shirt, obviously, right here on the press already. That's where the heat press is on this table. I've got my shirts down here on the little pull-out things. This is actually a computer desk. I've got my designs, I've got my T-tool, and then actually I have my iPhone 6 Plus sitting over here. I don't know why, but everybody always says, why do you have to call it your iPhone 6 Plus? Like, you're bragging about it. I don't think about that. That's what I call it, iPhone 6 Plus. That's what it is. Just because I'm a techie person, and I feel like OCD if I don't call it exactly what it is. I don't know. But people always say I'm bragging. I just randomly thought about that. But the reason I have it over here is the light on my phone, because we don't have a lamp in here yet. This is our only light.
We should probably invest a little
bit. This way I can see over on this side of the shirt. I take this measuring tape, which I've got to find it. Where did it go?
Is it underneath?
I had everything, guys.
The shirt? Uh-oh. This happens quite often. Yeah. We lose everything.
What I have to do is measure the shirt on each corner. So I start out doing it this way, because this way is the, it's the way I start out. It's the easiest way. And I pretty much, like, put it right at the corner, measure it down, see exactly where it comes to, and then I take it at this corner, and I do the same thing. This is after I've laid it on the heat press. I try to line it up as best as possible, and then I just fix it as I need to. Like, if that was offline right there, I'd have just, like, pulled it whichever way. I'll do the same thing right here. I'll measure it down from this corner. It's fine, I'm telling you. I'm comfortable with it. You measure it down to the seam, then you do the same thing over here. That's, again, why I got the light. Measure it down to that seam, and then I take the T-tool, which I'm not going to show you in this design. I'm going to go ahead and press this one because I don't mess it up. Actually, you know what? I think it's crooked. It looks kind of crooked right now. yeah, I'm going to fix it, so I guess I'll go ahead and show you. I just want to make sure it's right because it's been sitting here for a few minutes. All right, so I pretty much lay the T-tool out where I think it's centered, just like that. The design doesn't even have to be on it yet. Now, I know this from here to here is 16 inches, so I lay the measure across it over top of the T-tool. I was about right. See, I'm getting better at it. I notice every time I'm like almost centering it perfect every time. Okay, so you want it to line up with that line right at the 8-inch mark because it's 16 inches. And I try to line it up with the bottom of the heat press so like it's flush with that. So that way this line is straight. So my tape measure is coming loose. So I line it up with the 8 and the bottom of the heat press as perfectly as possible. I try to be really precise with this. Some shirts take longer than others. So the reason I do that is so when I do this, I know the line where it's off-centered because our designs aren't actually like laid on this graphic right, or maybe it is right because it's done this way. I find the little line right here in the S in Sleep Team, and I line it up with the left side of this line and just bring it down enough from the top. The top of the collar is right down there. I'm just showing you guys the whole process. This is how it works. Alright, I try to like look all the way down this line, and I just want to barely be able to see it on the left all the way up and down. If I wasn't talking, I'd be doing this faster too. I will say that. And I'll get better too because my first shirt I've done today. Alright.
And once you start doing it, you'll get like super used to it.
I mean, last night when I was doing it, now by the 9th shirt, I was like way faster at it. Here we go.
Yeah.
So if it works as far as the timer. Yeah, the timer's not working. I don't know why. All right. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Beep, beep, beep. Beep, beep, beep. Beep, beep, beep. And... ta-da! No sleep team.
That's really strange.
Yeah, I don't know why it's working, but it doesn't matter. I don't really need it because I can count to 10 in my head.
Yeah, but it's nice to have just in case you...
And look at that. Perfectly centered, perfectly aligned on the shirt. Like, that's amazing. I figured out how to do it perfectly right every time, as long as I take the time to do it correctly, which I do every time. I'm OCD about this.
As you guys can tell.
And then I lay my shirt up there. On to the next one. It is hot up in here. Good
gosh,
God.
Not too bad, but
okay, you're not the one saying. Yeah, you're not the one sitting beside this. This thing is freaking hot. So I'm done pressing for the night. I think I may come back and do some more. I don't know. I say that now. I'll probably be back in here doing more. Always like I'm like, all right, I'm done, and then I just go back to doing more work. I'm a work addict.
But we can snuggle. That sounds really nice. Good, doesn't it?
Yes. I want to get all these shirts done, though. I'm ready to have them ready for these
guys.
We've got a good amount done. All right, yeah, look, show them what we did.
We've got some small shirts.
So I did, like, I think, like, 10 shirts, maybe, in, like, an hour and 10, 15 minutes. So not too bad. I'm getting better.
Well, it's going to take time, and then you'll get, like,
a... Yeah, I was stopping in between, too. That wasn't, like, just shirt after shirt after shirt after shirt.
I like it because it's time for us to, like, sit and just... Breathing,
yeah, we can listen
we're
to
working and listen yeah, to a podcast.
We're listening to a podcast. We can listen to audiobooks while you do this.
Yeah.
We can literally read a book while we're doing this or listen to music.
But only if you wait for me. We have to listen to The Alchemist.
Yeah, that's one book that I want to listen to. All right, guys, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed today's vlog, click the like button down below. I have no idea what my mom did earlier, but I'm
all
sure.
All I know is she came by just like, I can't wait for you guys to edit this.
She's like, I enjoyed that. I like vlogging. I don't normally talk to myself anyway, so I got to talk to the camera. But yeah, I guess I'll see you guys tomorrow. Subscribe for new videos Monday through Friday. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we'll see you then.
That was a fail. Let's cuddle now.
Peace.
Oh,
I literally kissed your eyelash. That was weird.
I didn't know what you were doing. I didn't know what you were doing. I am so confused for a second. Peace.